Wouldn't it be great if you could access all of your calendars in one place? I mean, all of your Google calendars and Microsoft Outlook calendars, all of your work and business calendars from the very same screen. Well, you can, and you can also use all of these additional features for free with Woven. So in today's video, I'm going to give you a guided tour and give you three great reasons why you should check out this free calendar. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And the number one reason why you'll want to check out Woven is that you can bring in all of your calendars into a single place. I know for many of us, you don't have a choice as to what your work calendar is. You may use Google Calendar in your personal life, but perhaps you have to use Microsoft Outlook in your work or in your business life. Well, now you can bring all of those calendars in the same place and never have to go back to those other calendars either. Here, for example, I've got a combination of Google Calendar and Microsoft Outlook events here. And with Woven, it is a true two-way sync. I don't have to worry that something is appearing on one of those other calendars and not showing up here. So let me give you just a quick example. I'm actually going to open up Microsoft Outlook here. You can see I've got these two events, which do appear on my Woven calendar right here, my two lunch events. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a test event. And let's just call it something simple like that. I'm going to say test event. Okay, the test event from Outlook, just so we know which one we're looking at here. And why don't we make it an hour in length? And I'm going to say save and close. So here we have our test event in Outlook. Maybe this is my personal calendar and Google is my work calendar. Well, if I open up Woven again, you will now see that it appears here within my Woven calendar. I can see it, I can access it, I can change it. But what if I have to change the date? You know what? I have to move that till tomorrow at 1 p.m. So I'm going to move it over here. Let's jump back to our Outlook calendar. It may take just a few seconds, but there it is. Now it's updated here. Everything is in sync. So I never actually have to come back here to Microsoft. I can manage everything right here from within Woven. Now, the second reason why I think you're going to want to try Woven out for yourself is the ability to create templates. And templates can be so great because there's often times where you're creating recurring meetings that have the same information time and time again. Think about something like a team meeting where you're always including the same four or five people. Maybe you need to include a link to a particular document. Maybe there's a particular video conferencing link that you always need to add as well. So to create your own template, all you need to do is come up here and hit the plus button, and we're going to say template. We're going to create a new template. And in this case, I'm going to call this a client meeting, client review meeting. Let's do that. Okay, so this is maybe a particular meeting. I've given it a title, and now I've got this area here where I can create very specific details as to what I want to happen with that client review meeting. Now, my very first option here is to publish this as a scheduling link. We're going to come back to this so that you can use Woven to replace things like Calendly, so you can just send out a link and people can book time with you. But I'm going to leave that off in this particular case because I want to send out this invitation on my own. So I can come down here, and the first thing I can choose is duration. So for example, let's choose something that is maybe not typical. I'm going to say an hour and 30 minutes. I know for most of us, our default time within our calendars are probably a half hour or maybe 1 hour. And whenever you book a particular meeting that's different than that, you got to remember, oh yeah, I got to drag this down or I got to change the time. Well, the great thing about templates is you never have to do that. You can choose it here, and it's always good to remember that as we apply the template. Next up, we can choose our available time. So this is really key if you only want to schedule these meetings on certain days or times. So if I open this up here, I can say, you know what, I never want these client review meetings to happen on Fridays or Mondays. And you know, in terms of time frame, I always want to make sure that they happen in the afternoon. So I'm going to say 12 p.m. to 5 p.m. Now you can adjust a few other things down here in terms of no sooner than, no later than, and even include a buffer time. I'm going to come back to this in a moment when we start looking at that public link, but let's just keep this one relatively simple. We've added some specific timeframes as to when we want to have this client review meeting. I come back to the template area here. I can specify which calendar it's on, whether it's going to be on my Google calendar or my Microsoft Outlook calendar. I can give it a specific color as well. I can say that maybe these are going to be this sort of orangey color here. And then I can also choose my default reminder time, because maybe this is such an important meeting, I want 30 minutes in advance. Remember, you can only choose one default time within Google Calendar or within Microsoft Outlook. You'd have to come down here and remember, right? Every time you create that meeting, you have to remember to adjust that reminder time. Well, you don't have to do that with templates. And then at the very bottom, we've got several options here in terms of, do we want to add the same people each and every time? Is there a specific conferencing link that we want to add each time? So maybe if I click on this, I've actually already input a bit of information here earlier, just a fake address and a password, but this is always going to be included in this template. I don't have to retype it. I don't have to copy and paste it from anywhere else. All right, now that I'm good with this, all of my changes are automatically saved. Next up, I want to be able to apply this template. Okay, so when I come up here and I'm going to schedule a new event, I'm going to say new event, and here are some of my most popular templates. Here's my client review meeting that we just created. So I'm going to click on that, and what it's going to do is it's going to say, well, let's, you know, if you want to add any information or change any information, you can do so here. But I think the most key part is this one, find a time. Now you'll notice over on the right, it's actually highlighted my available times. Like for this week, this is really my only window of available time. Remember I said no Fridays and only after 12, between 12 and 5. If I go to next week, you can see I've got a little more time because I've got nothing scheduled and I'm available on that Tuesday as well. But let's go back here. So already it's telling me where I should be looking. I can click on this calendar. I can click outside of these times if I want to. But I want to come back over here to the left. If I say find a time, now you can see it's actually highlighted my only available time for this week. I can either click on these ones within the calendar, or I can scroll down and pick something in the future as well. Maybe I'm going to say, you know what? Yeah, 3 to 4:30, that sounds great. Let's set that time. There's that client review meeting. Again, I can still add and edit information here if I want on the left, but I'm going to say schedule, and now I'm ready to go. It's an hour and a half. I'm going to get that 30-minute reminder time in advance. Everything that I set up in the template is ready to go. Now, the third thing I want to cover today has to do with public links. And what do I mean by public links? Well, how often are you trying to schedule time with someone and there's all this back and forth, right? All this email back and forth or texting. Are you available here? No. How about this? No. How about this? How about this? No, no, no. Back and forth until you find the available time. Well, that's where schedulers like Calendly can be very important, where you can just send them one link and then they have access to when you are available and they can book time with you. Well, Woven has that built right in here, so you don't have to use a third-party application. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to come up here and we're going to hit plus again. We've got actually two options here when it comes to a scheduling link. We can choose a one-time scheduling link, mean that a person can only use this one time and you're only using this with an individual, or you can use a public scheduling link. And this is probably the more common one here, or the one that I think you're going to use more often. So let's create a public scheduling link. And I'm going to say that this is an interview with Scott. Maybe it's like a podcast interview or something like that. Now we're going to get an option here on the left-hand side, which is very similar to what we saw with the template before. In fact, many of the same options here. So here we have the publish as a scheduling link turned on. But before we copy this link and see what it looks like to the end user, let's just go down here and make sure that everything else is in order. So 1 hour, is that, you know what, I'm going to say 45 minutes. That's the length of time. Again, we've got our availability here. Maybe this time around, I'm just going to say no Fridays, and I want it to start after 11 a.m., right? That's when I'd like it to be no earlier than 11 a.m. I'm also going to come down here and take a careful look at the no sooner than and no later than. Now, this is important because chances are when you're sending out a public link, you don't want people to be able to book you within minutes of them receiving that link, right? You want to be able to have some buffer time. So I'm going to say, you know, you can't book me until, you know, 2 hours from right now, right? You got to give me some warning as to when I can schedule and fit this into my calendar. And I also want to give them so much leeway time. I don't want to give them my calendar availability for the next 12 weeks. I'm going to say, you know, you can book me out to 2 weeks. So anything between 2 hours from now and 2 weeks from now, that's when I want people to be able to book me using this calendar link. So let's go back here. As we saw before, we can choose the calendar, we can add conferencing information, we can add the description, everything that we like, but let's keep it simple and save it as is here. So already it's showing me this is what people could book me for this week when I send out this link, but let's see what it's actually going to look like for the end user. So here's the link here. We could edit the URL if we want to customize this a little bit, but I'm just going to copy this link and let's open up an incognito window here and paste it. So this is what your end user would see. When they click this link, they're going to see something that looks a little bit like Woven, like we see here, and they're going to be able to see the availability here. So they can either click on one of these time slots here right on the calendar, or they can look at sort of this column view here, right? They can scroll through and select a time that's available to them. So maybe they say to themselves, yeah, tomorrow, 2 to 2:45, that sounds great. That works with my calendar. I'm going to click that. All they have to do is input their name and their email address and schedule it, and it will appear on your calendar. So something that's going to replace maybe a cost or a third-party app in your life, you can do that right here within Woven. Now, if you'd like to use Woven for yourself, it is currently still 100% free, and you can do so at woven.com. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and if you have any further questions, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.